Hey. Hey, detective. What are you doing?
I found something.
Great. Was it alcohol?
God, no. I just got the wind knocked out of me. I think I know how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
What exactly does that mean?
Everything going back to normal.
All right. I found some more information on Dorsetto and the patients. There are some seriously strange things going on here. I'm pretty sure two of the patients are dead, and maybe even the clerk.
Oh, yeah. I kind of just gave up on worrying about that.
Well, just keep your eyes open, I suppose. What were you doing again?
Jeremy made a pact with the Dark Man to keep all the madness locked inside Dorsetto.
All right.
I'm gonna break it. I just have to... Where is it? Where's the talisman?
It's around your neck. I worry, Detective.
Don't, I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. At least you're a good distraction.
Trust me, you're getting your money's worth. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.
Be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that dick fella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. It ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Combi seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
The two orderlies still hadn't found Jeremy.
Christ! What the hell was that? Must be a spare key to Dr. Gray. I need the key. I don't have a combination for this. Maybe Jeremy did. It worked.
The last...
Dr. Gray's office, all to myself. Let's see if we can figure this guy out.
I have finished tidying up, Miss Beauregard.
This is where McCarthy has hidden my favorite young.
Dearest Dr. Manzetti, I find...
Detective Conby, good to see you again. Solved your case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink. Pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
There's something missing. Better hold on to these. Wouldn't want them to get lost.
McCarthy was a deadbeat. His mere presence annoyed Conby. It was like watching the worst version of himself mock.
I can't leave. I got a job to do. Selling that old barfly short. Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
Sometimes.
Take this much more. This has to end.
Radiography, patient Jeremy Hartwood, date. Hypothetical psychosurgery based on the ideas by Burkhart and the St. Petersburg research.
Mind if I do? That's better.
Dr. Gray had been putting Jeremy...
Why does this keep happening? What am I supposed to do?
And we're back here. Perfect time to have a look around this place. Jeremy's hiding, right?
Hello? Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait. Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking
Jeremy,
me.
Where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running. Boat's wedged itself right into the bayou. If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river.
Jeremy, where are you?
This definitely needs fuel.
Strangled all the life from my body.
Are you under the impression that you
No. I was supposed to die.
What does that mean? That you were supposed to die.
I'm the catalyst. I had to die to make the story happen.
What story? What are you referring to, Jack?
30 years ago, Frederick needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Find your focus.
Hey!
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Oh, everything is wrong. Nothing is in
place. I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Conby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
Jeremy was calling out for help, but Conby couldn't figure...
like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
Jeremy.
Brother, I need you to...
Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office.
It's blocked.
Lunacy and the Astarte Artist Colony, a monograph by
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
my room. I belong here. I know that number. Where's that from? I did this. I wrote that. I know the combination. I carry it with me.
Detective.
How long have I been here? Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing the shape? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
What the hell happened in here? This looks familiar. That's me, isn't it? How long had it been since I drew myself in drink and depression? And it all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. A welcoming dark voice wrapped around my mind like a heavy,
I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. So much back then. When was this exactly? What case was I working? I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state, but he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so. Principles keeping him from handing out information from his rules. So he needed some convincing. Well, every case can't be squeaky clean. Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. I don't remember this at all, but I can't say it didn't happen.
Thank you.
can't go that way. On my way to the hotel, the Morgan gang caught up. I owed them money, a lot of them. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. It's a stupid thing. They'd be back. I found it. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting of the signature, Ted Stryker. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room. Something about that name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. I recognize this room, but I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them, but where?
Yeah.
That's right, he was running away, ditching his old life and marriage in New Orleans to find something better in Tallahassee. And he took his daughter with him against the will of the mother. That's why she hired me. But I stopped him. I caught up with him at the Pearl River Bridge. Pearl River. This is where I caught up with him. This is what the dark man wanted me to revisit. But I'm still not seeing it. What am I forgetting? I can't believe I didn't recognize you.
I looked a little different back then, I suppose.
Was any of this real?
How do you mean?
This day, just... so much is happening. I can't... I think I've lost my head. Do you need me to apologize? I mean... I am sorry. I don't think I can even begin to explain. You're just a kid, Grace. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean for it to happen.
Lies. More lies.
No, really. I thought I was being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What is this for?
Some form of admission of guilt. Maybe acceptance. It's what the dark man wants.
I guess we just watch my father die again, then.
You think he's alive?
I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. That he will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him!
We? Do it yourself! I'm down there with him, remember?
Can I really save them? This all happened so long ago. I have to find a way to get down there. I have to see it with my own eyes. There was a boat at the house where I entered. If I can raise the bridge, I should be able to get to the car.